Hello everyone, in the present session, I'll explain zoning concepts. So first we'll take what is the definition of zoning. Zoning is an FC switch function that enables nodes within the fabric to be logically segmented into groups so that can communicate with each other. In the case of zoning, zoning is a function which enables nodes within the fabric to logically segment each other into a single group, and within the group those nodes can communicate. So that is called as zoning. So in the diagram we can observe that we are having, so this is one zone. So here we can observe that we are having one more zone, and here we are having one more zone. So within each group the devices or nodes can logically segment it, and within the logically segmented group the devices can communicate with each other. So we are having some parameters like zone set, zone and members in the concept of zoning. So first we'll take what is the meaning of zone set. Zone set consisting of combination of two or more zones. So that means here in the given example, the zone set consisting of around four zones like zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 and zone 4. And within each zone is it consisting of few members. So for zone 1, zone 1 consisting of member A as well as member B and member E. Similarly, under zone 2, it consisting of member A, member B and member C and so on. Members are nothing but the nodes within the SAN that can be included in a zone. Switch ports, HPA ports and the storage ports can be considered as members of a zone. Like the switch ports, HPA ports or else the storage devices are called as members of a zone. A port or node can be a member of multiple zones. The port or any node may be a member of more than one zone. Node distributed across multiple switches in a switch fabric may also be grouped into the same zone. Zone sets are also transferred to as zone configurations. Zoning provides control by allowing only the members in the same group to establish communication with each other. So that means within the zones, whatever the members or devices or nodes are present, so those devices can communicate with each other. So zoning is nothing but logically segmented group. Within that, the members within the zone can communicate with each other. So we'll take types of zones. So basically we are having the first category of zoning as port zoning. So in the case of port zoning, which uses physical address of the switch port to define the ports. So which uses the physical address, which uses the physical address. Physical address of the port, of the switch port to define the zones. So in the case of port zoning, access to the node is determined by the physical switch port to which the node is connected. So in the case of port zoning, access to the node will be determined by the physical switch port to which a node is connected. The zone members are the port identifiers. So port identifiers in the sense the switch domain ID and the port number to which HBA and its target device, target means the storage array or storage device, are connected. In a node, if a node is moved to another switch port in a fabric, then the zoning must be modified to allow the node and in its new port to participate in its original zone. So that means the devices or members within the zone may be a part of the other zone or the members of other zone. So whenever the nodes are moved into another switch port in a fabric, then zoning must be modified to allow the node in its new port to participate in its original zone. So next take the another category of zoning or types of zoning as WWN zoning. So as the name specifies, it uses worldwide name to define the zones. The zone members are the unique WWN address of the HBA and its target device. So zone members are the unique WWN address of HBA as well as the WWN address of the storage devices. The major advantage of WWN zoning is its flexibility. So it is more flexible compared with the port zoning. So WWN zoning allows nodes to be moved to another switch port in the fabric and maintain connectivity to its new partner without having to modify the zone configuration. So this is a major advantage of WWN zoning. So in the case of port zoning, whenever any new member is added into the zone, so the entire modification or configuration need to be changed. But in the case of WWN zoning, which allows nodes can be moved into another switch port within the fabric, and it can maintain the connectivity to its zone partners without having modify the zone configurations. So there is not necessary that the entire configurations need to be changed. So the last category is mixed zoning. So which combines the combinations or which combines the actual qualities of the port zoning as well as WWN zoning. So using mixed zoning, which enables a specific node port to be tied to the WWN of another node. So I can take a part of port zoning as well as WWN zoning combinedly, it can be considered as mixed zoning. So here we can observe that the types of zoning with examples are specified. So first we'll take zone 1. Zone 1 is nothing but WWN zone. So in the case of WWN zone, so I'll while specifying the zone address, so I can take WWN of the server as well as I can take WWN of the storage array. So WWN of server is given it as 10:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00: WWN of storage array, that is 50:06:04:82:0E8:91:2B:9E. So that is how we can specify WWN zoning. So the second zone is called as this one, that is called as port zoning. While specifying port zoning, so have to consider the switch domain ID. The switch domain ID is 15, comma, the input port number is 5. Input port number is 5 and port number is 5 here, and output port number, that is once again switch domain ID, comma, output port number is 7. So I can write port zone as 15:5:15:7, with where 15 is nothing but the switch domain ID, and 5 and 7 are input and output port numbers respectively. The last one is mixed zone. So in the case of mixed zone, as I specified before, so I can take WWN of the server, WWN of the server, this one. This is zone 3, WWN of the server, and I can take other side, I can take the port zoning concept. So the WWN of the server is 10:1, 00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00　the port which is connected to with which present within zone 3 is 12. So, comma, switch domain ID is 15, comma, 12. So, this is how we can specify different types of zoning. So, next we'll take FC SAN topologies. First, we'll take mesh topology. A mesh topology may be one of the two types, full mesh or partial mesh. So, in the case of mesh topology, either it may be full mesh topology or partial mesh topology. So, in a full mesh, every switch is connected to every other switch in the topology. What's the meaning of full mesh? All the switches are connected to, every switch is connected to every another switch in the topology. So, a full mesh topology may be appropriate when the number of switches involved is small. So, if you are having only limited number of switches within the topology, then only we can go for full mesh topology. A typical deployment would involve up to four switches or directors, with each of them servicing highly localized host to storage traffic. So, in the typical deployment of full mesh topology, so we can consider four switches, and all the four switches are servicing highly localized in order to transmit host to storage traffic. So, here we can observe that we are having the partial mesh topology and full mesh topology. So, in the case of full mesh topology, all the switches are interconnected. So, here we can observe that all the switches are interconnected. But here in the case of partial mesh topology, here the interconnection between all the switches is not considered. Only there is an interconnection between switch 1. Suppose if this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this switch is 4. So, I can take 1 to 2 is connected, 2 to 4, 3 to 1 to 3, 3 to 4 is connected, but there is no connection between this one. This is not considered. So, that is called as partial mesh. But in the case of full mesh, we can observe that there is an interconnection or physical path between all the switches. So, next we'll take core edge fabric. So, in the case of core edge fabric, topology has two types of switch tiers. The edge tier is usually composed of switches and offers an inexpensive approach to adding more hosts in a fabric. So, in the case of core edge fabric topology, it consisting of two types of switch tiers. The edge tier is usually composed or consisting of switches and which offers an approach to adding more hosts in a fabric. So, each switch at the edge tier is attached to a switch at the core tier through inter-switch link, that is ISLs. Benefits and limitations of core edge fabric. The core edge fabric provides maximum one-hop storage access to all the storage devices in the system, because the traffic travels in a deterministic pattern, that means from edge to core or core to edge. A core edge provides easier calculations of ISLs, inter-switch link load, as well as the different traffic patterns. So, in this topology, because each tier switch port is used for either storage or host, it's easy to identify which network resources are approaching their capacity, making it easier to develop a set of rules for scaling. So here, the core edge fabric topology is easier. Why? Because so we can easily identify which particular network resources are approaching their capacity, as well as easily we can calculate the ISS loads as well as the patterns to develop a set of rules for scaling. So next we'll take virtualization in SAN. So first we'll take block level storage virtualization. So in the case of block level storage virtualization, aggregates block storage devices, that is LUNs, and enables provisioning, that means capacity enhancing, of virtual storage volumes independent of underlying physical storage. So in the case of block level storage virtualization, which aggregates or combines block storage devices, that means LUNs, and enables expansion of the storage capacity or enhancing of storage capacity of virtual storage volumes. So independent of underlying physical storage. So here we can observe that the diagram shows the block level storage, and we are having the storage array. So these are the storage array, and we are having the servers. So here we can observe that there is one virtualization appliance, so which will enhance or provide the provisioning of storage provisioning with respect to the storage array. So we can consider the physical volumes we can make it appear as logical volumes or logical unit numbers or LUNs, so that the servers can directly access those informations present within the storage pool. So virtual SAN or vSAN. So virtual SAN, also called as virtual fabric, is a logical fabric on the FC-SAN, which enables communication among a group of nodes regardless of their physical locations in the fabric. So what is the meaning of virtual SAN? The virtual SAN is a logical fabric which enables communication within the group. That means within the group I'll be having nodes. So communication between the nodes within a group regardless of their physical location in the fabric. So if you are grouped some nodes together, irrespective of their physical connections, virtual SAN or virtual fabric enables the communication between those nodes. So communication between the nodes within a group regardless of their physical locations in the fabric. In a vSAN, a group of hosts or storage ports communicates with each other using a virtual topology defined on the physical SAN. So the virtual SAN can be implemented on the physical SAN, and we can consider a group of hosts or storage ports, so which can be communicated with each other using the virtual topology. So these virtual topology we can implement on the physical SAN. Multiple vSAN may be created on a single physical LAN. So there is a possibility of creation of multiple virtual SAN on the single physical SAN. Each virtual SAN acts as an independent fabric with its own set of fabric services such as name servers and zoning. So each virtual SAN acts as an independent fabric. So it will create multiple virtual SANs on a single physical SAN. But so those vSANs, whatever we created, so individual vSANs will act as an independent fabric with its own set of fabric services, such as, so it consisting of name servers as well as zoning concepts.